Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video today, I'd like to talk about the relationship between Activision and Call of Duty creators. As the current sitting CEO and president of the COD Shills Association, I think I'm more than qualified to talk about this. If you've never seen this channel before, and maybe you just come across it because of this video, my name's Prestige, or Ryan. I've been playing Call of Duty for nearly my entire life, and the first time that I ever had a chance to do anything associated with Activision was before the release of Modern Warfare 3, believe it or not. When my channel only had like 300 or 400 subscribers at the time, they invited me down to Infinity Ward to get a first look at Modern Warfare 3, which was something that I never imagined in a million years. At that time, I had never flown on a plane. It was very scary, but I took the leap, and I'll never, ever, ever regret that. So what ended up happening last night? Well, with the release of Season 3, of course, Activision did a briefing, a creator call that happened just a couple of days before its release. And through this call, they went over DMZ, they went over multiplayer, they talked about Warzone, they talked about big changes coming. They even spoke a little bit about the patch notes, but they didn't go into detail because they let us know that the patch notes were just going to be massive with sweeping changes, which made a lot of people really anxious to see what was going on. And I say anxious because when we're in a call like this, we don't have hands-on with the game. There's not someone there with a demo showing us the movement changes. There's not somebody there with a video showing us the movement changes, or at least the past few calls that I've been in, that's never happened. This is just one of those situations where, as creators, we can only go based off of the word of the developers. And one of those things that we've always been taught over the years is to never trust a leak, to never trust anything that's not coming directly from the horse's mouth. And when a developer is telling us that one thing's going to happen, and we echo that as messengers and say that this is going to happen, and then it doesn't, well, as creators, it just makes us look stupid. In fact, it makes our communities upset at us because we were just being the messenger at that point. And the thing about the Season 3 call, because I can confirm I was there, I listened to the entire thing, there was a lot of conversation about movement. People were asking questions about being able to slide and shoot at the same time. And when they gave us a little information about movement updates, they said that you're going to be able to slide a little bit faster. It's going to be like a little more accelerated. You'll be able to get back into the fight faster after diving. And then someone asked, point blank, in our community, can you slide and shoot at the same time with this movement update? They said yes. There's no misconstruing that. There's no leak. There's no rumor. That is what the developer said that was asked that question by someone in our community. So when we hear about massive changes that could really change up how movement works in general, of course people are going to hype the fuck out of it because they want Warzone to be in a good place. They want Warzone to be in a place where people enjoy it just as much as they did with the original Warzone. The problem with these calls is they reveal what they want to reveal. They don't give us all of the information. We don't get to see an early build. We don't get to play an early build. We don't have to, you know, got the opportunity to do things like this. Sometimes we do if we're invited to the studios, but recently it hasn't been happening that way. It's pretty much been a PowerPoint or a slideshow where we go through everything that's happening. We talk about specific things. In certain cases, they'll even bring up the patch notes, but with this specific call that's causing a lot of controversy right now, none of that happened. And speaking of things that didn't happen, I've seen a lot of people, of course, coming at COD creators saying, well, if you're in this call, why didn't you tell them that you hated the idea of these pay-to-win DMZ bundles? The simple answer to this is, we were not told about it. We just never learned about it. They talked all about Black Cell and how that's going to change the battle pass, but they never once brought up that this is going to be the way to get the next active duty slot. They always just showed us with four available. They never once told us that there would be DMZ bonuses in a bundle with the active duty slot. And I guarantee you, the reason they didn't tell us about this is because they knew it wouldn't be well received. They knew that it wasn't the way to go about doing things. And they would have been flamed by every creator that was on that call, especially the ones that are specific to DMZ, because they were not happy to hear that news when it finally was revealed to the world when the update came out, because we found out as everyone else found out. And the same thing goes for not being able to shoot and slide at the same time, not really seeing too many sweeping changes to the movement as much as we thought that we would see, because that's how it was presented to us in the call. there's a misconception from our community that if you work with Activision in any way, or if you go to these calls, that you cannot say what you want to say, that you can't speak your mind, that you're not allowed to say anything negative. And that's just not true. And even if it wasn't the case, even if there was a stipulation where you're not supposed to say something negative, I would never follow that fucking rule. I'm not a mindless bot. I'm not going to sit here and just agree with everything that the game does, because I don't agree with everything that the game does. And that's clearly evident of the videos that I've been making since before the launch of Modern Warfare 2. I promise you, just because I say something positive about Season 3 or positive about a map isn't because I was paid. It's because I genuinely like the thing that I'm praising. There's no reason to be fake in that regard. If you can't be honest and truthful with yourself, then you cannot be honest and truthful with a community that you're trying to foster. And that's one of the main reasons why Call of Duty is in the place that it is now, because they're not being honest and truthful with the community that they're trying to foster. That's why they hid these DMZ bundles. That's why they hid the fact that you can't get an active duty slot by just playing the game. They didn't mention that in their blog post at all. They never said, hey, you can get an active duty slot by buying it in a bundle. They never mentioned it. They just said that there's going to be active duty slots. That's all they said. And in order to escape the criticisms, they just say, well, we never lied, because they never brought it up. Or they say, oh, well, you didn't ask specifically about supply drops in BO4. That's why we brought something called reserves. It's not the same. They're clearly different. That was a whole nother situation that got me in a bunch of fucking hot water back during BO4. It's why in certain cases, I just choose not to say anything. Like in the case of this phone call that we ended up going to before the release of Season 3. It's not that I wasn't impressed, because I definitely was. The developers really made it seem like this was about to be a sweeping change and the game was going to feel completely different. And that just wasn't the case. And it was one of those situations, once again, where I wanted to see it. I needed to see it before I believed it. And I'm really fucking glad I didn't say anything, because I was just as excited as many of these other creators, because I'm a huge fan of Call of Duty. I want to see it succeed. I want it to get back to a place where it feels like, as a community, we're not just a bunch of dollar signs. I want it to feel like there's actually a community there where we can talk genuinely about the game, and we feel like it's doing something great, and we could talk about all the awesome things that are happening, and we can have these discussions, because in the moment, everything is perfect. We haven't had that in a long, long time. And it just seems like every single step of the way, things have been getting worse and worse for people that enjoy specific aspects of, well, Modern Warfare 2. And I heard someone say, I don't remember who said it, but it was a perfect way to kind of sum up MW2. This game is like a jack of all trades, master of none. Basically, they're just sticking their hands in every type of game mode. We got, you know, raids. We got ourselves with Spec Ops. We got ourselves with DMZ and multiplayer and campaign. And we got the wars on the BR aspect. And they're trying to do all these things. They're not really mastering one thing. When you look at it, it's like an ocean of content. And then you start to wade into it and you realize it's only about an inch deep. It goes far. There's quite a bit there. Don't get me wrong. But it's not for everybody. Not every single person is going to play every single aspect of this game. For example, I'm not a Warzone fan. I enjoy it from time to time when Plunder's there. Once again, another misstep. Plunder wasn't there at the launch. It's going to be added at Season 3 Reloaded or something around that time. And yeah, then I'll jump back in and start playing again. But as of right now, I have no interest in jumping into Warzone. It's not a game that I particularly enjoy. I'm already pissed off that all of the skins that I paid for back for the past 3 years were wiped off the face of the earth and they don't come back. That was a misstep in itself. Misstep after misstep after misstep leads to people feeling like there's no hope left for a franchise that they grew up with and otherwise might actually love. It might be their favorite game of all time. And it's true. Call of Duty captured lightning in a bottle once, and it did it twice with the release of Warzone a few years back. But in their efforts of trying to one-up themselves, all they've done is strip away what they've created, trying to reinvent the wheel while pushing away a community that already enjoyed the product that they made before. It isn't about reinventing yourself every single year. It's about maintaining that community like they did for the past few years with the original Warzone. up into the bittersweet end. I'm not even a Warzone player, and I understand the feeling that people have in this moment. It's the same feeling that I've been having for the past few years as a multiplayer fan. I feel like we've been left in the dust in lieu of other opportunities, and Warzone was that opportunity. They handled it well with events, they did it well over the past 3 years, but now Warzone is in the same exact spot that multiplayer was during Vanguard. It's a very sad situation. And at this point, Call of Duty needs to stop trying to one-up itself in order to appease investors. They need to stop trying to reinvent the wheel by taking away features that were crucial to not only creators that like to use them, for example, theater mode, reintroduce concepts that were already there years ago with the original Warzone. Why do that? Why do it? It's just not an enjoyable situation. It makes it look like the game was unfinished and it just needed to be pushed out in order to make a quota. We don't want to be treated as numbers. We don't want to be treated as dollar bills. We don't want bundles pushed down our throats. We just want a Call of Duty game to feel like a Call of Duty game again. And it's so tone deaf to see the Call of Duty account just sit there and tweet about bundles every single day, when we just want some communication about when the game is going to be fixed. So, in closing, I just want to say this. In the situations of being excited about changes, in a game like Modern Warfare 2 that's been so dreary and gloomy and just full of negativity, when we're told directly from the horse's mouth that big changes are coming, but not only that, it was told to us in an excited fashion. Unlike the previous call where they kind of felt like scared, like they didn't want to be there, the developers this time were like super stoked. They were like, guys, we cannot wait for you to get your hands on this update. It's going to be massive, which it's true. It is massive. There were a lot of balancing changes. There were a lot of updates. Obviously, the one-hit kill sniper is a good change for those that wanted that in Warzone, but it's not exactly what was promised based off of the hype that was surrounding the videos that creators were making at the time. And I understand that as the perspective of a Call of Duty fan and a creator myself. I totally understand that. We were hyped because the developers were hyped because they were promising us all these things, and it just never happened. So whether it was misconstrued or misunderstood, I don't exactly believe that. I think it was just fans of Call of Duty being excited for something different, and unfortunately our hearts were crushed when it wasn't exactly what we wanted. Let me know your thoughts in the comments section below. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you enjoyed, drop a like, subscribe for more, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace.